Hey guys, Angie Monson. Today I'm going to be teaching all about posing. So it's very different to pose people that are individuals and groups. And so I'm going to show you kind of the difference in my approach and my mindset while I'm shooting, and like tons of little tips and tricks that I've learned over the years that I hope you can take to your next photo shoot. Okay, so today we have these wonderful models, this beautiful family here, and I am going to first talk about how in family photos I want to feel like create a image where it feels like really together and close. And that's why I want their heads on like a very similar height. So it's a little tricky because, you know, kids are so short and then parents are so tall. So you have to think of different ways to get creative to get all their heads close together. So it feels like this warm, loving feeling when you take their picture. So we're going to come over here. We're going to photograph this gorgeous, cute little family. So I'm gonna have Eli, can you kind of lean your head on mommy? Good job. And then can you, let's see, can you put your leg up a little bit on the couch? Your foot up? Like you can hold, no, put it like all the way up like this.
All the way up on the couch.
Yeah, on the couch, yep. And then like let your knee fall, cute. And then let's see, Rumi, let's have you kind of lay on mommy's lap a little bit. Yes, oh that's cute. And then cross your feet at the bottom. And then always like really paying attention to how the light is hitting them too, because you can kind of see like, I probably want to move the couch a little bit this way so that they're not getting like raccoon eyes. We're in a studio, so obviously we're using the light from the window, the natural light from the window. Oh, you guys, I love it, so sweet. Oh my goodness. Okay, so when I am photographing families too, obviously I give direction, but I want to like constantly be telling them like, good job, move in this way, like make it really positive. If you aren't talking at all, they're gonna be confused, like am I doing the right thing, kind of thing. So this is one of my huge goals when I'm shooting families or groups. I want all their heads close together. So that's my first tip of the day. One of the biggest tips I give people is just to put all your weight in one leg. So see how the mom has all her weight in one leg? She automatically looks natural and it doesn't look like she's trying to pose or do anything special, but she looks really natural and I don't feel like I have to give her a ton of direction after that, because people just kind of fall into their natural state. You're back to her a little bit so you can turn towards Eli. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. I try not to photograph them just straight on, because most people don't have a symmetrical face and body, and so it's a little bit more attractive to shoot from the side. So, like, I just have her turn a little bit so her kids can kind of lean on her, and they're holding hands, and they're not just like putting their arms around each other in the back. They've got their hands together in the front, and then he can kind of hold. Can you turn towards mommy a little bit and hug her? Yeah, there we go. And then put that hand in your pocket. Put that hand in your pocket right there. And thumb out. Yeah, what a stud. Okay, love her. How much do you guys love your mommy? You love her so much. That's adorable. I love that. Okay, look right here, Rumi. Do you see a puppy in my camera? Do you see it? Okay, so now we are going to be shooting an individual, which is very different than shooting a family or a group of people. I feel like this can be harder for some people and then easier for others. I feel like it's almost about the same hard for me, families and individuals, because they don't have anyone to lean on or to touch or to interact with. So teaching them to feel confident and comfortable in their own skin while you're photographing them is a little bit hard. But once you kind of get them to loosen up and you're building that rapport with them, you can see that their body just starts to relax, and that's what I want in the photos. I never want them like sitting up straight and being perfect, because that's not how we are in real life. So the first tip I want to shoot, or I want to talk about, is leading lines. So to make a photo interesting, having lines that lead to your subject. So our subject is Alexa, and we want lines leading to her face. So when I'm shooting, it's really easy to say, okay, I'm just going to shoot straight on at her face, like her against the wall or something. But most of the time, people's faces aren't totally symmetrical. So using like diagonal lines to lead to their face can make the image look a lot more interesting. So I'm going to have her lean into the armchair right here. And so we have this line leading up to her face. And so I can get kind of a close-up shot. Perfect. And again, I'm using my 50 millimeter 1.4 lens. So we have like these lines, these diagonal lines that are making the photo much more interesting instead of just shooting her straight on. So if I just shot her straight on, just look at me, put your hands in your lap, just put your feet on the ground. So this photo, it almost looks like a school shot, like what you would get at, you know, like Olan Mills or something. It's just kind of boring and they're looking at the camera and there's not really anything interesting happening. So you want to always think of those leading lines that are going to lead to your subject. Okay, so this is a pose I use a ton. Having someone sit on the ground and you're kind of shooting down on them will always create beautiful catchlights in their eyes. But what I want to teach with this teaching point is having people have their hands near their face to kind of make the image more interesting. So I have her sitting down right here against the wall, and see how her leg is kind of bent over. This is flattering on like any body type. So if someone is like insecure about their stomach or they want to kind of like hide that, not that at all you have that issue, but some people are like really insecure about that. And so this is like a pose I use all the time. But what I'm going to actually have you do is put your right elbow to your knee, and you're going to kind of like just keep your hands really soft. Yeah, beautiful. And so I'm going to get, these are going to be more close-ups. So I'm going to basically be shooting from like her elbow up and get those really beautiful catch lights. Put that elbow and drop it. Yeah. And then we have that nice diagonal line leading up to her because I'm shooting this direction. Okay. And I love even like shooting in this direction and getting her whole body in this shot because it just makes the image so, I love how it's framed, like how you're in this against the wall and these lines are leading to you and the way your pose and your shoes, like it's all just working together. Okay, so this is just always an important tip, right? Light is so important. You don't want to be having to fix your photos later. You want to enhance them. So I always try to get light first. So I'm kind of having her face the light, but turned a tiny bit. So we have some shadows. So you can control, like if she was facing me like this, her face is just gonna look all lit up. It's very flat light, okay? Because the light is coming through these windows directly onto her and it's just really flat, okay? But if I have her turn just a little bit, it creates these like cool little shadows on the side of her face, which I think makes it a little bit more interesting. Paying attention to catch lights in her eyes, that little white reflection on her eyes, those are the catch lights. But, so I just wanna kind of have hers turned a little bit sideways, and we're just focusing on getting really quality light. Like I said, it will make your life so much easier in the editing process. Look out the window. And I like getting images that aren't just looking at the camera, kind of shake it up a little bit. Hey, if you guys liked this video, click subscribe. Also, I have the full video available at my store and I will link it in the comments. I don't know if you go, if you're cool.